I finally caught them a few weeks later, out in the middle of nowhere. His car just pulled up onto a dirt path.
What was he doing, Mr. West?
I'd been staring at photos of Katie every night for the last month. The ink had started to run off where I'd been pressing the corner so tightly.
What was he doing, Mr. West?
He was admiring his handiwork.
I wouldn't worry, Mr. West. The chances are it's what she wanted anyway. To be one of his works of art, so to speak.
Fuck you. I was ready to put a bullet in the back of his head there and then. It would have been so easy, so satisfying. It was what he deserved.
What changed your mind?
I'm a cop, Darius. The American people rely on figures like myself to uphold the law. Killing him would have made us one and the same.
How very noble of you, John.
Once again, fuck you. But you know, the world is a funny way of showing gratitude for such selfless acts.
I assume you're referring to the blinding light that apparently engulfed your car.
I still have no idea what it was, or what caused it. I guess this terror of darkness has somehow found a friend in the light. And of course, when I came to, I found my car had made a strong connection with rather incompatible foliage. Worse still, my back seat was devoid of serial killers.
We'll be right back.
The descent, a violent maelstrom. Nature has a way of bringing the most devious of minds back down to earth. And shortly after the sawmill massacre, our psychopath succumbed to the outdoors of all things.
Really now, Mr. West, can we stop with the cliched storytelling? This isn't a tale from Narnia. How could you possibly know his motivations for being in that wood? Perhaps he wanted to feel closer to nature. Perhaps he was tired of killing. Just maybe. He wanted to feel closer to his victims.
All I know is, when the cops turned up to search the surrounding areas, they turned up nothing. And this was a place right out in the middle of nowhere, so it wasn't like he could have gone far. There was only one possible explanation. He'd managed to hitch a ride out of there.
You think he called the paramedics himself?
Well, it makes sense, right? Splatter yourself with some of the blood at a mass murder scene, and the medics aren't exactly going to be picky about who they pick up. He's breathing, so you get him to the wagon ASAP. Of course, this particular victim was breathing a little too well for his or their own good. I guess they may be adding a new phrase to the ambulance protocol handbook. Never give drugs to a psychopath.
His craft continued onwards for the next few weeks at pretty full force.
As I understand it, his newfound experience with medicinal drugs really got him fired up, correct?
He just became unrelenting, and the public were completely losing confidence in the police force. Well, no. They'd already lost all confidence. Now they were forming task forces and going out onto the streets themselves looking for him. He even had followers by this point. Groups of people who saw what he was doing as some kind of means to a human utopia. We just couldn't keep up with him.